Good morning everyone. Today we will learn about a data structure in C, that is array. An array is defined as the collection of similar type of data items stored at contiguous or continuous memory locations. Arrays are the derived data type in C programming language which can store the primitive type of data such as int, double, float, etc. It also has the capability to store the collection of derived data types such as pointers, structure, etc., which we will learn in the subsequent classes. The array is the simplest data structure where each data element can be randomly accessed by using its index number. C array is beneficial if we have to store similar elements. For example, if we want to store the marks of a student in 6 subjects, then we do not need to define different variables for the marks in the different subjects. Instead of that, we can define an array which can store the marks in each subject at the continuous memory locations. By using the array, we can access the elements easily. Array allows random access of elements. Here I have listed some properties of arrays. Each element of an array is of same data type and carries the same size. For example, integer equals to 4 bytes. Elements of the array are stored in contiguous memory locations where the first element is stored at the smallest memory location. Elements of the array can be randomly accessed since we can calculate the address of each element of the array with the given base address and the size of the data element. Now, this is how a C array is declared. The data type, the name of the array which can be given anything of user's choice, and the size of the array as the user wants it. This is the example. Data type is int, marks is the name given by the user. 5 means we need 5 space to store 5 elements. Now we will execute a simple program where we declare and store values of elements in an array and then print those elements. Now let us go to Notepad++ and start the program as usual by including the header file stdio.h. Now we start the main function int main. Let us declare the array as data type int marks. Suppose we need to store marks of 5 students. Always remember, give meaningful array names so that you get to know what values are stored in the array. It is for the ease of the programmer. Let us write a comment stating that this part is declaration of the array. Next, we will initialize. How to initialize? The first element of the array will start with index 0. Let's store the marks 80. The second element will be stored in index 1. Let it be 67. The third element will be stored in index 2. Let it be 46. Fourth element will be stored in index 3. Let it be 70. And the fifth element will be stored in index 4. Let it be 86. So we have stored the 5 elements. Now for traversing the array from the first element to the last element and printing the elements, we use a loop. Firstly, for the loop, let us declare an iterator I equals to 0. Now we'll start the loop. for I equals to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Why have we taken less than 5 and not 5? Because I stands for the indexes of the array, and this indexes start from 0 and move up to the length of the array minus 1. So since your length of the array is 5, the indexes will move from 0 to 5 minus 1, that is 4. That is why the loop will start from 0 and end at 4, that is less than 5. It will not continue up to 5. So always be careful, you have to consider the loop up to 1 less than the array length, not up to the array length. Now we will print the elements of the array and separate it by a space, marks, and within the square brackets we will have I, which is the iterator. Now we end the for loop, and once I has iterated over all the elements of the array, the loop will break. We write the return statement, return 0, and we end the main function. Now let's save this program and execute it to see how an array is printed. Let's save it as carray.c, and now we go to command prompt and compile the program first. So the program has compiled successfully. Let's name it as gcc-o arr carray.c. So we have pressed enter, and now let's see what is printed. See, you can compare it. I have entered index 0 as 80, so the first element printed is 80, second element 67, so here you get 67, third is 46, so you get 46, fourth is 70, you get 70 here, and fifth is 86, so you get 86 here. So the elements are printed in the order they were given as input, and they are also elements are also stored internally in contiguous memory locations, and that is why it is said that it is possible to access the elements of an array randomly. So this was how we declare, initialize and print the elements of an array. It is very simple and it will become easy if you keep practicing. So we come to the end of today's lesson. Thank you.